this session, I'm going to demonstrate how to create queries from multiple tables in an Access database. We'll create those queries using the query wizard. And then in the next session, we are going to do the advanced query method. In order for us to create queries from multiple tables, we need to first make sure that the tables have been linked via these relationships here. So you can check that from the database tools and then relationships, and you should see these links. And notice here that we have the customers table, which is linked to the contracts table. So let's say that we want to create a listing, or a query as the technical term is, of the customer ID, the first name, last name, street address, and then the city zip state. And then we want to also list the contract information for these customers. So here's how we do that. We'll close this first. And now we go here under Create, and then we go under Query Wizard, and then click on OK. And then we are going to go first to Customers. We're going to pick customer ID, first name, last name, state address, city, zips. And then we go to the next table. Here we go under Contracts. And then we'll pick up the contract number, and then the amount, date, and type. Then we click on Next, and then click on Next again. And then here we could have some kind of meaningful name, and then Finish. Notice at this point we have the list with the data that we requested, customer, first name, last name, and such, and the data has been pulled from both tables. So that is creating a query using the query wizard. You could do also the similar thing as well if we save this. Now we can go and create one for invoices. So let's say we want to see the contracts and how many invoices remain to be paid. So we go here under Query Wizard and then go under Simple Query Wizard again. And we can do this with two other tables. So we can go under Contracts, we can get the contract number, and then we can go under Invoices and then pick the invoice number, the date, and whether it was paid or not, and then Next, and then give it a meaningful name, click on Finish, and here we have the contract number, the customer ID, the contract amount, date, the type, the invoice specific number, the date that the invoice was issued, and whether the invoice was paid. So next we are going to learn how to utilize the advanced queries in a database. In this session, I'm going to briefly demonstrate how to utilize the query design in Access 2016. So far in our Access tutorial, we have learned how to use the query wizard in defining and designing a query. But in most cases in Access 2016 and previous versions of Access, a more effective way to utilize queries and design queries is to use a query design. The way that works is that instead of you going through step by step and adding specific fields in a query, you can actually design this query using this method. So to utilize the query design, we click here on query design icon. And then the big idea here is that you pick the tables that you want to work with initially. So in our case here, the tables have been linked by using the relationship module that we saw earlier. And now we'll pick the tables that we want to utilize and then click on OK. Typically the relationship looks like this. So we have customers, then we have contracts, then we have invoices. The way it works is that you have these tables here with all the different fields from each table. And you pick specific fields from each table and you're creating a new query. So for example, we want here first name, last name, and let's say the invoice number. And typically you can either double click on these fields that you want to add to the query down below, or you can simply drag these fields down here like we did a moment ago. If you double click on this asterisk sign, it will insert all the fields that are part of that table. Now here we want, for example, the invoice number, the contract number, and I'm double clicking at this point, the item, and the amount. And then we want also whether it was paid or not. Now let's assume that these are the fields that we want in our case. Now you can run this and see what it looks like. Notice you have the first name, last name. Actually, they are kind of backwards. You can readjust that. We can go back and readjust it. And we have invoices paid or not. If we want to tweak this query again, we go here under design mode and go into design view and then tweak this again. So if we wanted, for example, first name to be first, simply drag this to the left. And once we move the fields the way we want or customize this view the way we want, then we can run this again. And now notice first name is in the beginning and then you have last name and so on. So that's how you briefly utilize the query design in Microsoft Access 2016 in an Access database. Notice as well, if we go back here to the design view, you can define the sorting order. You can define specific criteria, whether the criteria is either or different various criteria by various fields here. And that's what we'll learn next. And before I finalize it completely here, notice also there are additional parameters that you can utilize here, and we'll cover these shortly as well, such as the query builder and the totals field and such. In this session, I'm going to briefly demonstrate how to utilize criteria, how to define the criteria within a query in Microsoft Access 2016 using the query design. So here's how it works. Let's say we have this query here called invoices and contracts. Actually, we have not named this yet. It's query number one. We go here under query design view. And now let's say that we wanted to see, for example, only the invoices that have not been paid. If we go under the invoices table and notice here that this is a yes or no field to enter a criteria. So we see only the invoices that have not been paid. We go here under the design view. And what we want to do is here under invoices paid, notice there is an option for criteria. There is a row here that we can put a criteria for this specific field. So we want to display only the invoices that have not been paid. In that case, we want to display those that meet the criteria for no. So we simply have to put no in there and now click somewhere else outside of this area and then run this query. Now notice it's displaying only those that have not been paid. If we wanted to display the text here, whether yes or no, or invoices paid, or with the wording no next to it, just to be sure, we make sure that this check mark, and by the way, that should be there automatically, make sure that it has the check mark right here. Now, if we go and run it again, notice it says invoice paid no, and it's displaying only those. If we want to hide that field, we go back to the design view and then just take out the check mark and then run it again and it will not display it. So that's how you insert a criteria within a query using the query design. Now you can have multiple criteria as well. If we run this query right now, notice that there are invoices ranging from $1,000 to more than $30,000 here. So let's say we want to see only the invoices that have not been paid of greater than $10,000. So to insert that criteria, we go back to the query design here. And then under the amount for the specific criteria, we want to put them so the both criteria would be met. We say greater than equal 10,000. And then click anywhere outside of this field and then run this. So we are saying we want the criteria, all of these fields, plus the amount needs to be greater than or equal to 10,000, and then the invoice needs to be not paid. We run this, and now notice we have all these invoices displayed. The other thing that we could do is we could sort this And we can go back here to the design view again and customize this further. So under the sorting criteria, we say we want to sort this in descending order. We want to see the largest amounts first, followed by the smallest ones. So notice we are doing three things so far. Click on run again, and now notice the $105,000 invoice comes first, and then the rest are following that. Then if we go back to the design view, we could even insert as many criteria as you want, and I hope you get the idea. So you could sort, for example, by a specific zip code or by a specific city and so on. Under city, for example, if I wanted to add an additional field and I want to insert it right there, just simply drag it in there, and then we could have various criteria. So right now I don't have any criteria by city, and if I run it, notice it's just going to display the city. But let's say that I want the city Lansing or Holland. So I want to display those two cities. Now in my case here, I can go back to the design view and I'll enter two criteria. So one of them will be Lansing. Now you have to type that correctly. And I can say or Holland. So it could be either one of them. And then run them. Notice it is displaying only the city Lansing or Holland, but then notice that the criteria is not quite what we were expecting earlier. Notice that we have 2500, so it's no longer just 10,000 or more. The reason for that is because we have here in our criteria stating that the criteria could be Lansing greater than 10,000, an invoice is not paid, or anything from the city called Holland. So we either have to move this up here or utilize the criteria either or that we were using earlier, but then keep in mind that it's not going to apply. So we have to put them like this with the or here and then the additional two criteria. Then we run it and notice these are the only clients that have not paid their invoices yet with the greater than 10,000 balance, and only Lansing or Holland just for those two cities. So that's how the query design works with multiple criterias within the query.